Yeah, this year the DES conference is in this beautiful ecosystem of allied arts. We put it here on purpose. The conference series started off at Cairns, at the Great Barrier Reef, at the biggest visible ecosystem that we can see, humans can see. Now we are here right in the Silicon Valley ecosystem, and something happened. Jenny Huang from AT&T, she got in touch with us, with her seed initiative. So what can be put in as a framework, and what specific projects can be displayed concerning seed that are really innovative on one side and that matter to the people on the other side? And from my perspective, I'd like to bring in an idea from Professor Weizsäcker, who lives close to my house. He is the current president of the Club of Rome, and he calls it Factor 5. So people lose their sense for resources, whether it's energy, whether it's food, whether it's time, or whether it's money. And with the same resource, you can achieve much more. Let me give you an example with energy. If you change a light bulb to an LED, you have reached a factor 10. If you educate kids in a different way, from kindergarten age, for example, if you let them sense the nature at the same time to make them aware about the potential of technology, you can reach as well a factor 2, 3, 5, or 10, perhaps. In my case, we run a forest kindergarten. It's a holistic kindergarten that leads kids from the age of 3 to 6 not only explore the nature, but companies make excursions and interact, even with different cultures, through Skype. So to blend this in the lifelong learning situation from early childhood to the age of when you are retired, and bring in your expertise for a kid or a community. That what motivate me, and I hope us very much that optimistic that we can continue very strongly what we and Jenny have initiated.